really hard to come here in the 60s and 70s and all that. And it was absolutely no-no. They didn't let any rock bands in. I mean, obviously, they had their home rock bands. They had their own rock bands, and they were sort of played. There was a big underground scene here, but it was even hard to get tourist visas. I tried to get a tourist visa a couple of times. I didn't want to know.
And it was always sort of half on, but always eventually off, you know, and you sort of gave up in the 80s for a bit. And it's just really nice, you know. I mean, it's the sort of place you never expected, I never expected to get to, you know.
There was always trouble, wasn't there? There was always communism and things. Things like politics that I don't like to get involved in.
We always have Moscow, particularly on a list of, you know, when you're going to play these tours, you have where you're going. We'd never got it.
We tried to come on our last tour, but I can't remember why the stadium was not usable. It was falling to bits, basically.
Yeah, it's been totally refurbished.
Yeah, and we couldn't come 3 years ago, so, which we could have come 3 years ago, but we couldn't because the stadium was falling to bits for another completely different reason. So here we are now, finally. Well, I mean, it's incredibly grandiose in scale. I mean, it's what one sort of forgets. I mean, it's just very, very large. I don't mean the amount of people, but just the architectural space and the use of the space and so on. It's very large everywhere, very grand and so on.
Rolling Stones have performed in over 1,000 shows throughout their career. Playing such diverse places, they often tailor their gigs for specific audiences. But did they pick up on any Russian vocabulary this time around?
I'd usually do, you know, I usually do some attempts at the local language. So sometimes they fall. I get a great cheer and I think, great, and I go to the next phrase and they all look at me like... So I can always cheat, say it in English first and then I say it in the local language. This is a good treat. But, I mean, I managed to finish in Estonian, which has got to be... That's the most tricky. It's the worst. I mean, it's much more difficult than Japanese. And, but, so, yeah, I'll have a bash. I was young, I was foolish, I was angry, I was vain, I was charming, I was lucky, tell me how, I changed.
The band are now receiving some of their best reviews ever, and with a back catalogue of songs spanning 35 years, it's hard to know exactly what to expect.
We do, through the decades, give them a pretty good cross-section of the Stones' music through the years, and that's the best thing we can do at this time, you know, like one gig, give them a good cross-section, and I'm sure, or I hope they'll enjoy it as much as the rest of the unplayed territories did.
With the Bridges to Babylon tour covering 20 countries in just 11 months, it's hard to imagine how the Stones keep up their momentum, emotionally and physically.
It is a little bit taxing on, like, just when you think, oh, let me have another hour in bed or something, you know, you've got to get up, you've got to do this, you've got to go there. So, in a way, it's your own fault if you don't get to bed and have enough rest.
Actually, you get far more tired in the first month or so because you're still not quite roadworthy, you know. I mean, you're still getting used to that moving and... Yeah, but after that, you kind of click in, you know. I mean, there are times when everybody's like, I'm knackered, man, you know. But at the same time, it gets easier once you get into it, you know.
But I've got to admit, I'm not going to lie to you, because it's almost a year I've been out and it's... You know, you're bound to get a little bit, but yeah.
Are you keeping it going?
Had 2 days off, so I'm all right, yeah. Since the last show, it would be cool. But no, I'll be fine to the end now. Just got another month or so.
playing music, I mean, if you know, you've got to go where the crowds are, you know. The travelling aspect of it, you can either look upon that as a real drag. Some, you know, some people do. I mean, I think we, none of us actually in the band do, but that's what puts a lot of people off the road, I think. But to us, it's always travelling is always, I mean, you turn it into a plus and they say, well, you know, eventually you get somewhere that you haven't been before, and that's, this is like an adventure for us, you know, even though we like the kids here.
The life of a megastar is not always easy, as the Stones can confirm. A grueling touring schedule such as theirs can, at times, be tough on those family members left behind.
No, it is tough, but then Europe's not very big. Compared, you know, like when you're in Japan, you feel a really long way away, but here they can come more easily.
I hate it. It's one, that is the hardest bit of touring, trying to keep that together and being away. I mean, doing this for a living, it's all very romantic. But it's hell if you're married. Your love is strong, and you're so sweet.
You make me hard, you make me weak. Earlier this year, the Rolling Stones were forced to change their European tour itinerary following an accident at Keith Richards' home, where he sustained injuries to his chest and ribs after a serious fall.
The shelf fell down on me, it was amazing.
It was a relief, actually. As long as he didn't kill himself. Now we've got, oh, great, a couple of weeks off, a couple of more weeks off.
Yeah, that healed pretty quick. I was lucky in a way, a strong stock, I guess. You know, I amazed the doctors. That was probably my aim, you know. But, yeah, everything fine, yeah.
Because, I mean, you said Moscow
was
always...
Yeah, it was a big one. Well, I'd like to go to China, but they don't allow any rock bands. Only Roxette's been to China. I met her the other night, actually. Roxette went to China and they stopped the show after half an hour. It's tight. So I'd love to do that, and I think that'll happen in the near future. And I'd love to go to India, too. Lots of people have been there, but it poses one or two problems.
OK. So when you're coming to the UK, because people are very disappointed, what happened there?
Well, the UK, it was one of those really... You know, it was awful. I mean, it's fantastically disappointing for, you know, people that bought tickets, and it was also fantastically disappointing for me.
The UK section of the tour was postponed for a full year when Chancellor Gordon Brown made changes in the tax laws in the 1998 budget.
It was just one of those things. We based this whole tour around a certain amount of financial rules that we'd set up. You know, we'd set them up maybe a year ago, and when those rules got changed by Gordon Brown's budget, we were really left with no option.
It's to do with the new tax thing, and so we just sort of put it off, you know, I mean, for now, because nobody could, like, figure it all out in time. And, you see, I mean, it's all right for us. We don't mind paying the extra. You know, you expect, especially with a Labour government, to get, you know, rich and rich bashing going on. That's cool, you know. But the fact is that it affects all of our crew. It affects security, except everybody that has been told that they're getting paid this much, and, you know, so they've... And if we hadn't, so they would have had to pay a load more tax than necessary, because they're lumped with us, and that's not really... we couldn't figure out, you know, that's not really fair. We don't mind getting bashed, but we couldn't let everybody, as with 300-odd people, getting bashed as well, you know.
So I was left, personally, with paying a fortune. The difference would be a fortune.
We were sort of forced to postpone them to next year, so we're going to do the shows in the UK, and we're going to do them next June.
So, although we apologise to the British public, it wasn't our fault, and we will be there next year, so that's even better.
And that, of course, was the Rolling Stones, and that...
Was after George Michael, huh?